Hello guys, I'm Kirti here from ThinkQuestion Software and I'm welcoming you in our Core Java session number 4. If you are remembering, in last session we had studied how to create class, how to create object, okay, also how to write methods as a part of class. We also studied how to invoke methods after creation of object. I can use that object to invoke methods. And yes, we have focused on how I can keep some accessibility restrictions by using some access specifiers given in Java, like public, private, protected, and default. And yes, there was one more important concept we had touched, that is encapsulation, one of the basic, what you can say, important concept of object-oriented programming languages. Okay, so to achieve encapsulation in best manner, we studied how to work out how to use getter and setter methods and what is its purpose, right? Now, in today's session, in this video rather, we are going to see few more concepts. Like, we will be focusing on one special category of methods. I am calling it as a special methods, okay? That is nothing but constructor. How to write constructor in Java class. Also, we'll see one more object-oriented programming concept, okay? Not fully, but yes, we'll just touch that concept today and we'll try to implement it by using something called as method overloading. So we'll try to achieve polymorphism today and we'll see the concept of, what you can say, static variables, static methods, why they are required and how to deal with them. Okay, so basically when we build simple Java class, okay, so scenario was somehow like this. Take example of this movie class that we had drafted in our previous session. Okay, so in movie class I had some instance variables. Okay, these are instance variables. We saw the reason why to call them as an instance variable, because these variables will have their separate copy in each instance, in each object. Okay, then we had drafted some methods like accept details, show details. Okay, and yes, we had some entry point for execution, say main method. So if I want to create object of some particular class, say if I want to create object of movie class, then what I want to, I mean, do, that is, you just say movie, then give some object name. We had given, like, my object was Titanic object and I created it like this by saying new movie, right? And what was happening with this object creation in memory, that is, one movie type object was getting created in memory heap and that was having some default values initialized for all these instance variables, that is year of release, profit, producer name and actor name. These all were initialized in that object with default values. Means what? Year of release, since it is integer, it was being initialized with 0. Okay, then profit, this was float type, so it got initialized with by default value as a 0.0 in that object. And likewise, your producer name and actor name, it was initialized as a null value. So if I want to utilize this object, I mean, further to have some meaningful value stored in that object, what we need to do, that is, I have to call some method with that object. Okay, observe here, we had drafted some method like accept details. Okay, remembering, so accept details method, it was having facility to pass some parameters in it. So whichever values I want to assign to those all instance variables of that object were being initialized within this method. So to put some meaningful values or to initialize that object with some specific values, I need to call such method with that object. See this line again. Okay, I have to call this method, that is Titanic dot accept details, and then into bracket, according to this specific method, what you can say, signature, or which type of parameters and how many parameters and with which sequence I have passed. Okay, accordingly I am passing some actual values so that these values will be initialized in that object to respective instance members. Okay, so this was necessary statement. I mean, otherwise that object would be with the default values. Okay, now can I make it more simple? I mean, each time, why I have to call this specific method to initialize values in that object? Other way, it could be what you could have drafted some setter methods. Okay, in last session we studied getter setter as well. So you could have drafted say methods like set year of release, set profit, set producer name, set actor name. Means again that four methods I have to call to set some values in that respective variables for that specific object, right? So this is not coding efficient way, right? It is not a coding efficient way. I have to write so many statements. Okay, instead of that, is there any a simplest way or a coding efficient way which will save my time also and which will help me to get my object ready with some meaningful values at the time of its creation only? So if I want to get it done, means now I expect the moment my object gets created in memory, automatically it should be initialized with some values, not by default values, but the values that I want to initialize inside it. Okay, so if I want to do this, there is one special provision given, there is one special concept given in Java that is nothing but constructor. Okay, what is it? Constructor. So constructor is what? That constructor concept, I mean constructor, you can say it is a kind of method only. Okay, means as in this class here we have show details method, we have accept details method, likewise whichever constructor will draft, no, that would be one kind of method only, but that would be special method. Okay, that would be special method. Why it would be special method? Because its name will be same as that of your, what you can say, class name. Its name will be same as that of your class name. So such method drafted in your class will be called as constructor. Okay, then how it would be making our life simple to initialize object at the time of creation only? Okay, see, understand, when we create an object, when we'll create an object, okay, so here this specific object, say movie, is being created in this way right now. Okay, so here you can say this is something like a method call only, no? This is something like a method call only. But the thing is, the method with this name I had not drafted in my class till now. Now I am thinking to draft it. Means what? I want to draft a constructor in my class. So constructor, as I have told you, it's one of the important point, one of the characteristic is what? Its name will be same as that of class name. Okay, so constructor is a kind of method only, but its name will be same as that of class name. What I mean to say, so see here, what is my class name? My class name is movie, right? If I want to draft constructor in my class, what will be the name of that constructor? It will be same as that of your class name, means its name also would be movie. And it's a kind of method. Okay, it is a kind of task, it is a kind of method. Okay, so it would have some definition also along with it. Okay, now the question would be, see, in case of accept detail as a method, you were saying that this method after completion of task, it won't return anything. So that's why here you are writing void. So in that way, if I'm saying movie as a constructor method, if I mean this is a method, then it also should return something. No, means I have to mention some return type here. Okay, so try to understand, constructor as a special method doesn't return anything explicitly. So that's why even you are not expected to write void here. This is not allowed. Void also is not to be written with your constructor. Why? Because constructor never returns anything explicitly. Okay, then if this method is drafted here, what is the purpose of this method? What is the purpose of this method? Try to understand. This constructor kind of method, or we can say constructor as a special method, it is provided just to initialize your object at the time of creation. Okay, so how we create object? Just remember this statement. How we create object? That is, each time if I want to create object of movie class, then I will say new movie. This statement is actually creating an object. Okay, whenever I use a new keyword, that new keyword is helping me out to create object of that specific class type in a memory. And yes, on left hand side, after that we are just referring, we are taking its reference into that movie type of variable, that is other part. But this is actually creating an object of that movie class. So what I expect, okay, I mean, what will happen over here, as we saw, this, what you can say, movie type object will be created automatically in a memory heap. Okay, some memory will be allocated. Okay, if you are remembering that diagram, in cloud shaped memory heap we have seen, and in that, when I say new movie, some memory for that object gets allocated. But at the same time, automatically this constructor also will be invoked. Automatically this constructor also will be invoked. Why? Because here you are saying new movie, no? Here you are saying new movie. So what kind of method it will try to invoke now? A method which is with a name as that of class name, and that will be invoked automatically, and such method is nothing but constructor. And as I have told you, what is the purpose of this constructor method? That is to initialize the object as soon as it gets created in memory. So when I say new movie, the object has got created in the memory. This method will be called at the same time automatically. So let's achieve our purpose. Let's try to put some meaningful values in that object, right? So over here, if I just try to set some values for year of release and all that stuff. So if I say year of release, how much it should be? I mean, the value for this is a, let's try to put these values only. What is it? Say, if I want to create a Titanic object and I want to get it initialized with these values. So I'm just putting it. Now, there is no need to use this specific method. We are not supposed to give call to some explicit method like accept details. Okay. So I'm just doing some another provision. I'm saying, say year of release, let it be how much? Say 1997. Then what should be the value of profit? What should be the value of profit? So profit, let it be say 120,000 as a float type value. Then what should be the name of say producer? So here we are saying producer name is equal to say Mr. James. I'm initializing it with that value, and this is what my actor name. So what is the actor name? That is Leonardo. Okay, so I made some provision by writing some special method in my class whose name is same as that of class name. Okay, and such method which is having same name as that of class name, we are going to call it as what? Constructor. So here this constructor method or this constructor is not accepting any parameters here. So this type of constructor is called as default constructor. Try to understand, these constructor methods, they are of two types. They are say one of the categories is a default constructor and another category is what? Parameterized constructor. So right now we are focusing on default constructor. Why we are calling it as a default constructor? Because if you say this constructor is not having any parameters passed inside it, so such constructor is called as default constructor. I'm just writing it for your purpose here. What is it? Default constructor. Okay, so this default constructor, when it gets invoked, when it gets called, as a developer, do we need to call it as we were calling accept details method or show details method? So to call the method, what we were saying, that object name and method name. Okay, if I want to call accept details method, I would have called it like object name and method name like this. Right? So do we need to call this specific constructor method explicitly as a developer? No, you are not needed to do that. Why? Because this constructor will be called automatically when you create object of that specific class in a default way. Means what? Here I am saying new movie, and here in movie I am not passing any parameter. So it will automatically call this specific constructor. My control will come here in memory heap, whichever what you can say object has got created. In that object, it will set year of release as 1997, profit as some value, producer name and actor name like this. Okay. So when I try to, I mean, if you want to get it clear in more pictorial way, we can visit that, I mean, we can see some picture here so that you will understand it in better way. Okay? See here. What is happening now? When I'm creating an object of movie class, okay, we said movie Titanic is equal to new movie. Okay, so this new movie, it will try to create object of movie type in memory heap, right? So here, this is how in memory some movie type object would be created. Okay, and are you able to see? Now it would be available with some default values initialized in it. I mean, not default values, the values that I had given in default constructor. Why this happened? Because when I call this specific statement, when this new movie as a statement gets executed, internally what will happen? Okay, internally this object in memory heap will get created, step one, and at the same time this type of constructor, I mean default constructor of your movie class, also will be invoked. And in default constructor, what task we had done? That is, we were assigning some values to these all variables, no? We set some profit earn, we set actor name, we set producer, we set year of release. So automatically that values will be initialized in this specific object, and this object reference would go on stack. So this Titanic as a reference, where it will be stored in stack. So that is what is happening when you are creating an object, and this is how at the time of creation of object only your object is getting initialized with some meaningful values. So why it is possible? We could achieve it because of internally default constructor has been invoked, and whose name was same as that of your class name, that is movie. Understood this? So here now let's realize this. Let's try to understand this. I'm removing this statement now. Unwanted statements, let's try to remove. Okay. Now say this. What we are trying to do, that is, we are just displaying what is stored in that object now. So after object creation, values initialize in object. Okay, so in this statement what we did, we tried to create object. Okay, so once object has got created, internally what it is calling? It is calling default constructor. Default constructor is a constructor which is without parameter, that has been called. It helped me to initialize these all values to that specific object. Right now in our case, that object is nothing but Titanic object. Okay, and that object is ready for my use. I can use it for my any purpose. So suppose I want to peep in that object and I want to see what are the details inside it. So here what we are trying to do, after object creation, now I want to just confirm like what are the values in that object. So I'm just calling which method with this specific object, that is show details. So show details method, when it will be invoked, it will show us what are the values initialized in that. So let's confirm it once. Okay, so what we are saying now, let's try to execute it better way first. Okay, so I'm executing this now. I've saved the changes, and after creation of object, I have not called any method like accept details. Still my object will be ready with some meaningful values. That is the magic of constructor. This is how it works. Okay, so are you able to see the output? So once object is ready, in that object of Titanic, you have these values ready for your purpose. Understood? Okay. Now let's say we'll try to create one more object. Okay. We'll try to create one more object. Say, I'm saying, what is it? Movie. I want to create one more object, say Uri. Okay. Is equal to new movie. And obviously here as well, object will be created in memory heap that would be referenced as a URI, And in that object, at the same time, to initialize some meaningful values, what type of constructor will be called automatically? That is nothing but default constructor. So automatically my control will come here to this default constructor. It will try to set year of release, profit value, producer name and actor name for that URI object as well. And now if I want to say what is there in that after creation of URI object, what is there in that object? So if I call some show details method with it, so after creation of, here I am saying Titanic object created. And values initialized, you are able to see here. Likewise, now I want to see what are the values initialized into your URI object. Okay, so for that we have called again show details method with URI object, right? And let's see this now. Okay, so here I should say what, URI.showDetails, because I'm interested to see values from that, no? Okay, so when I execute this, now what you are able to see, that is in both the objects there are same values which has got initialized. In both the object same values has got initialized. Why? Because I created both objects in a way by saying new movie, and each time two different objects has got created. One has got referred as a Titanic, one has got referred, because this is a separate memory, no? In memory it would be a separate object, please understand. Okay, so two different objects has got created and two references has got stored in stack, that is first was Titanic and after that now URI object. But for both objects when they created, what type of constructor has got invoked? That is default constructor only. And in default constructor, whatever I had told, that has been initialized into that objects. So in both we are able to see same values. Okay, so I actually don't want this to happen. I was expecting, or I need some different variety of values, I mean, in URI object. Okay, so how it can be done? So again, for URI object, should I call that accept details method explicitly? Means is there any other solution? Yes, there is a solution. There is no need to call such different, accept details like method to put different values in this. What is the solution? That is, you can write your constructor along with the parameters. Okay, you could have drafted one more constructor at a time in your class, okay, and that would be along with a parameter. That is possible. We can pass parameters to constructor. Right now here, whichever constructor I have drafted, this movie constructor, okay, this movie constructor, it was not having parameter, so we called it as a default constructor. Now I expect it should have some meaningful values. I mean, there should be some constructor which will help me to initialize my object at the time of creation with some values that I want to set. Means I want to customize the initialization. So if you want to do that, there is a provision, you can write something called as parameterized constructor, okay, wherein I can have some parameters passed inside it. Suppose I'm trying to pass some integer type, say year of release, okay, then I'm passing some float type, say profit, okay, then I'm passing some string type producer, and I'm passing string type actor. So let's initialize this value here. So let me say it is as PR, because P already we have used, right? So I'm trying to initialize year of release by Y value that I have passed. I'm trying to initialize P's value as a profit, and here I'm initializing producer name with PR variable's value, and here I'm trying to initialize actor name with variable A. Okay, so now are you able to see? Again, this is a method with same name as that of class name. Okay, but what is the difference in between this method and this method definition? I mean this method and this method declaration. Okay, in this specific method declaration, we had not passed any parameter, so that's why we called it as a default constructor. But here, this constructor is drafted along with the parameters, that's why we will call this constructor as what? Parameterized constructor. It is what? Another category of constructor. Okay, so this is parameterized constructor of your class. So at a time I can have such many more constructors in my class. Okay, but please make sure in while drafting more than one constructors in your class, you have to take a precaution. That is, each time while drafting a constructor, its declaration, okay, it should be with different set of parameters, different type of parameters and their sequence. Okay, I mean here we cannot expect that I will write one more movie as a default constructor, and here year of release I will set some different value. Okay, and let me initialize some different values here. Okay, so this is not possible. Your compiler will not allow you to write constructor with a same signature. There is a concept called as signature. Okay, if you just see method signature, what does it indicates? That is method name. Take example of this accept details as a method. Are you able to see? I have selected it for you. Accept details is what? A method name. Okay, now what do you mean by method signature? So method signature, it means name of the method along with how many number of parameters it is taking. So here in accept details, how many parameters are there? 3. What type of parameters they are? Integer, float and string type. And what is their sequence? First is integer type, second is float type and third is string type. So this whole thing, whatever I have selected here in front of you, is called as method signature. Okay, so while drafting constructor, you have to make sure you are allowed to have more than one constructor at a time in a class, no problem. But each time the signature of that constructor should be different. I mean here, movie constructor, here it is without any parameter. There is one more movie constructor, but that is with 3 parameters, okay, with their different types and their different sequence. So these two definitions at a time we can write, no issue at all. Now how this constructor, I mean when this constructor will be invoked, that is when we'll try to create a movie object with this style, I mean with 3 parameters, like integer, string, I mean 4 parameters, integer, float, string and string type. Okay, so let's try to do that. Now I want that URI object should be initialized with different set of values that I want to set. I want to pass that values. So while creating this URI object, okay, here what I'm saying, say here what is the sequence of that parameters? That is, first is, what is it? Integer type, year of release, then profit. Okay, so what I'm saying, integer type year of release for URI, say it should be 2019. Then profit should be 250,000. Okay, and then what is it? It should have some string type producer name and actor name. So producer name I'm saying, say Mr. Chopra. Okay, and actor name I'm saying, say Vicky Kaushal. Okay, so these are the different values that I have passed to this constructor right now. So what will happen? When your object will be created, another object with reference URI, okay, when it will get created in memory heap, okay, automatically it will call, okay, your runtime environment will call which kind of constructor of this class? That is parameterized constructor. Okay, so parameterized constructors with first value as an integer type, second float type, fourth string and third also string type will invoke this specific definition of constructor. It will receive that all values respectively in this parameter, and it will try to set those values to your, what you can say, object or instance variables. Okay, now once this object is created and initialized in a memory, its reference it is written in this Uri reference, I mean Uri as a reference name, which is of movie type. So here what you are able to see, when we are, say it is something like calling a constructor and creating an object. Okay, so how constructor is being called? It is being called automatically when you are creating the object. Okay, so it is calling that constructor method here. Okay, that constructor method will work out. Okay, but I mean it is not returning anything explicitly to the calling statement. Okay, here we had not even mentioned what is its return type. Okay, so when this object gets created and it gets initialized with this specific values, though we have not specified any return value explicitly here, we are not having return statement also and return type. Okay, since return type is not there, no return statement. Okay, but still this specific, what you can say, object creation statement implicitly means internally, it returns reference of that memory where that object has got created, and it stores that reference on left hand side in that type of variable. That is what will happen. So in case of creating movie object like this, okay, when I say only new movie, it calls which type of constructor? Correct, default constructor. It initializes object in default way, and when I try to create a movie object with some four parameters in it, it will try to exactly match that sequence over there. Means if I do some mistake, no, so if by mistake I pass this year of release after profit value, okay, after profit value, then my compiler is taking objection. Why? Because there is no such constructor definition in which you have passed first parameter as a float, second as an integer. No such constructor is drafted. You have constructor which is having parameters in a sequence. First is integer, then float, then string, and then string. Okay, so it will strictly check, are you calling object, are you creating object with that specified what you can say syntax, I mean sequence of parameters only or no, and if it is matching, then only that will be called. So here I'm passing first as integer, second as a float, third as string, and fourth as string. Then internally it will call default, I mean parameterized constructor. It will try to initialize these all values in that object. And now if you could execute this here, you will be able to see that is what your URI object has got initialized with different values in it. I'm running it for you now. You may realize it in output. So here Titanic object has got initialized with these different values, and URI object has got initialized with these different values. Okay, so are you comfortable? Have you understood the concept of constructor? Okay, so here when we created this specific object, no, internally what happened? Okay, just see this. Internally it has, so with this statement, internally it has created object of movie class, okay, like this. And it has also initialized that object with the values that you had passed in this constructor. So this new movie, and with this set of values, it is what creating that specific, I mean calling that specific kind of constructor. Okay, so this is how your parameterized constructor will be drafted. So I hope you are clear with what is constructor, when it gets invoked, basically why it is needed, what is the need of constructor. Constructor helps us to initialize object with meaningful values at the time of creation of object. Okay, means when you create object, automatically constructor will be called. That is number one. How we should draft it? So constructor is a special kind of method whose name should be same as that of your class name. Are you allowed to return anything? Are you allowed to mention any return statement with a constructor? No. Constructor never returns anything explicitly, so there is no need to specify any return type. Okay, instead of saying no need, we should not write any return type over there with your constructor. Okay, what is another point? Constructor as a special method gets invoked automatically when you create an object. So here in slide, when I create an object by saying new movie with some parameters, that type of constructor it will invoke to initialize the object. If I say only new movie, it will call which kind of constructor? That is your default constructor, right? Okay, so while learning a constructor concept, also let's try to understand there is one keyword given in Java that is called as this keyword. What is that? This keyword. Okay, in last sessions slightly we got introduced with this, we are trying to utilize it also, but let's try to focus on this keyword properly. Okay, so this is the keyword. Okay, and for what purpose it will be used? Okay, its first purpose is what? To refer current object. For what purpose it will be used? To refer current object. Okay, likewise there is its another purpose. What is it? That is to avoid shadowing of instance variables. This point yesterday we have, what you can say, experience, but we'll revisit it again. To avoid shadowing of instance variables. Okay, okay, and the third reason for what purpose we can use it, that is to call one constructor from another constructor, that is for constructor chaining. Okay, so we are going to experience this basically, how this keyword will be helpful. Now since I am drafting it in a Eclipse only, compiler will generate error. Let me keep it in comment right now. So this is what we are going to see. We are talking about the purpose of using this keyword. Okay, so this keyword in Java, how it helps us to refer current object, let's see that. Okay, now just come up here. Now say, take example. Here, when I call some behavior, some method with that specific object, say Titanic, when I'm saying Titanic.showDetails, where my control comes? It comes to this method. It comes to this method, okay? And here I'm trying to show some profit value, some producer name, some actor name, and some year of release. So this profit, producer, actor, and year of release, whose profit, whose producer name, and whose actor name it tries to show? It tries to show all these values, okay, of current object. Means all the values of that object with which this method has got invoked. Currently, I have called showDetails method here on this statement, on this statement with Titanic object, no? That's why in showDetails when I come, it will try to show all instance variables value which are belonging to Titanic object. Now the question is, in case if I want to see, we have seen one of the way, that is if I want to access the members of that class and if they are accessible outside as well, okay, then there is one standard way, that is object dot, when I use it, it tries to give me the members availability for that specific object. Means in that way if I want to access it, okay, here for example, right now in our case, this show details and all, right now they are default, no? Okay, means this specific class, we are dealing with the same package. I have written main method also here. So with Titanic, if I say Titanic dot, it is able to show me actor name, producer name, profit, year of release, right? Okay, so this is how I could have displayed it, no? Means especially I can have four statements written in main only, saying system.out.println profit is titanic.profit, system.out.println say actor is, what is it, titanic.actor, okay? But this I have to do for all number of objects, for every object I have to call such methods, right? And that is not affordable. Further, if I want to display details for URI object also, then for URI object again, are you going to see these four statements, that is system.out.println actor name is URI.actor name, system.out.println profit is URI.profit. So this would increase the code length, no? So that's why this behavior of each object, okay, this task for each object, I have drafted only once as a template in my class. And with which object I want to behave like this, with which object I want to execute this specific behavior, I should call that along with that specific object. So when I say titanic.showDetails, it will show me the details of Titanic object. In Titanic object's memory, which is profit, actor and all that stuff is stored, it will show me that. If I call uri.showDetails, then it will show me the details of uri object. Okay, so when I come inside this method to perform that task, suppose for some purpose I want to refer the current object. Okay, for some purpose, if I want to refer the current object, then how you will refer that current object? That is, you will refer the current object just by saying, what is it? This. So inside this method, when I say this, this means what? The current object. Okay, so current object means what? Right now, if I am calling titanic.showDetails, so when I come to show details, okay, then here this reference, sorry, I placed it in wrong position, I should use this keyword here. Okay, so here this keyword is referring to whom? It would refer to the Titanic as a current object. So from that current object, the profit is to be displayed, no? So I could have referred it like this. I could have specified it like this as well. So this dot profit. This dot profit means the profit of that object whose details you wanted to show, that is Titanic object. If I said this dot producer name, means what? The producer name of current object. Okay. So in that way, this helps you to refer current object. That is its first purpose. Okay. But always it is not necessary to say, because your current object, okay, it gets referred implicitly, automatically. Automatically it consider this as a this dot producer name. Automatically it is considering it as this dot actor name. There is no need to write this dot explicitly. Okay, but explicitly sometime we may need to refer current object. So at that time this keyword is going to help us. So how and where that situation will be, let's turn towards that. So first purpose of this keyword, are you clear with? So first purpose is what? To refer current object. Now second purpose is what? That is, if I want to avoid shadowing of instance variables in the method. Okay, so what do you mean by shadowing of instance variable? Let's retouch that concept. Okay, let's take example. Here in accept details, I am passing some parameters, and say one of the integer type parameter that I am using to initialize year of release, suppose coincidentally its name, that local parameter, I mean formal parameter, whatever I have passed, if its name is same as that of your, what you can say, instance variable name. So the local variable name is also year of release, and the instance variable which I want to initialize by this value, its name is also same. So if I keep it like this, there would be conflict, no? I mean, I was expecting instance variable year of release should be initialized with local variable year of release. But that is not happening. So your instance variable is being suppressed. Your instance variable year of release is being shadowed. It is being overlapped. So this should not happen. So specifically, if I want to give hint to my runtime environment, that is, boss, current object ka year of release, you please try to get it initialized with local variable year of release, whatever I have passed. So this is how now it is avoiding overlapping or suppressing or shadowing of year of release, which is instance variable. Okay, so let's try to realize this. How we'll just draft it with a constructor. We have studied constructor just now, no? Now suppose I have parameterized constructor, and coincidentally in parameterized constructor, whatever parameters I have passed, that parameter names are same as that of my instance variables name. So I'm passing integer type year of release, then I'm passing float type profit. Okay, so instead of p here, I'm just saying, what is it? Float type profit. Then I have some producer name as one of the local variable. Okay, so it is what? String type producer name, and here I have string type actor name. Okay, so these four parameters in this parameterized constructor, coincidentally their name is same as that of, what you can say, instance variables name. And here all my instance variable names are being, what you can say, suppressed. They are being shadowed. Okay, So to avoid that, means here if I say same thing, here if I say put this local variable's value year of release into this instance variable year of release, put this profit, which is a local parameter, inside this profit, I'm expecting it should be considered as what you can say instance variable, but that is not happening. So this shadowing, if you want to avoid, you please mention, use this keyword here. Using this keyword, you can refer a current object, and you say from current object year of release, I want to get it initialized with what you can say local variable year of release. Okay, here current object's profit, you try to get it initialized with local variable profit. Current object's producer name, you try to get it initialized with local variable producer name. And in same way for your actor name. So here I will be saying current variables, I mean current object's actor name, that is this dot actor name, you try to get it initialized with local variable actor name. So here what we achieved, we try to avoid shadowing of instance variable. So this is how we can use this keyword for that. So by making this change, you won't be able to see any kind of difference in output. Our outputs would be same as you have just saw, I mean before few minutes, okay? But your current object was being referred with this. That was one of the thing, okay? So this is its second utilization area. Now let's turn towards how I can call one constructor from other constructor. See, it is possible to call one method from other method. Do you remember in one of the class that we have studied in previous session, that is account class, I guess. So from open account, we tried to call fill, what is it? Some method was there, like fill account details method. So from open account method, I call fill account details method. Okay, yeah, we'll say it again here. Suppose there is one accept details method, and from accept details method, if I want to call show details method, I can call it directly like this, right? I can say show details like this. So actually we have studied show details of what will be the question, no? So always your class methods needs to be called with object. So have I used any object here? Have I used any object here? There was no any object mentioned explicitly, but implicitly there was an object, okay, which is internally its reference is available. The current object, when I came inside this accept method, what is the current object? So current object will be that object with which I have called accept details method. Take example here. Suppose I am calling, okay, just forget about these statements right now. Okay. Suppose I am creating this Titanic object, and with Titanic object I said, what is it? With Titanic object I said accept details. Okay. And here I am passing some values. Okay. So first is integer, second one is float type value, third one is some string type value. So I'm trying to call this method like this. So when I come to accept details method, when I come to that specific behavior, with which object I have called it, that is Titanic. So when I come inside this method, the current object, this means what? Titanic object. So while accepting the details, while performing that behavior, with the same object I'm trying to call show details. Though we had not mentioned any object name here, internally implicitly this will be always referred as a current object. So whichever current object you had given, that current object will be used to call that method. This is how it will be internally considered. Okay, so here what we are trying to do, okay, if I run it, while accepting means first accept details method will be called, and after accepting details, after performing that task as a part of that method only, your show details method also has got called. Okay, now in same way means this is how you may call one instance method from another instance method, I mean of the same class. Okay, now same thing I want to experience with constructor. Okay, means what? Suppose, see, constructor is a method only, but it is a special method. So suppose from one constructor, if I want to call another constructor, is it possible? from one constructor, I want to call another constructor. Yes, that is possible. Okay, so how we will call it? So should we say it like this? Suppose I came to movie. Okay, when I will come to this movie constructor as a default constructor, when I create object of movie just by saying this statement. Okay, when I say movie Titanic is equal to new movie, so this will give call to what? Default constructor. So when it comes to default constructor, right now your default constructor is trying to initialize that Titanic object. Right? But now what I expect, instead of doing this initialization task through this default constructor, let me call parameterized constructor from this constructor. Means from movie constructor, I want to invoke parameterized constructor of movie class, which is with four different parameters. So is it possible? Yes, it is possible. And this can be done. Okay, to achieve it, again this keyword will use us. Again, this keyword will use it. It would be helpful to us. So how we can do that? So when I say new movie, my control came to default constructor. Now in default constructor, if I want to invoke some parameterized constructor or some other constructor, okay, then I can use this keyword in this manner. So this into bracket. Now see, if I want to invoke parameterized constructor, then I have to pass the parameters which are mentioned in that. So first is integer type, second is float type, third is what? Your string type, and fourth is string type. So I'm trying to pass that type of parameters here. So year of release, say 2009, then profit value for that particular movie is say some 5000, you can say crore. Okay, so I'm just saying, I mean, take it lightly, jokes apart. So it is something like, it is some float type value I'm setting. Then I have some producer name, say Mr. P, okay, and I have some actor name, say some JO. Okay, so this statement which you have drafted as a part of your default constructor, okay, will invoke this type of constructor. This type of constructor means the constructor of same class, okay, which is with these type of parameters, these number of parameters. So your control will come here automatically. It will get that all values received here. 2009 will come here, then whatever profit I had given, some producer named Mr. P, and this all will be received here. And that object which is being constructed right now will be initialized with this specified variable values, and after that your control will come back. Understood? So this is how I can call one constructor from other constructor of same class, and this you may call it as constructor chaining. So to achieve constructor chaining, which keyword has helped you? That is this. Okay, so this is the third utilization of this, that is to call one constructor from other, or you can say in constructor chaining. But here, point to be remembered, suppose let's assume here there is one more constructor, say movie, and in which I have only two parameters, say integer type, year of release, and I have float type profit. Okay, so P. So only two things I am trying to initialize. That's possible, no problem. So here I am saying year of release is what? Y, and profit is how much? That is whatever I have passed in P. So these two things I am trying to get initialized. Okay, so again this type of definition is allowed because its method signature, okay, it is having two parameters, int and float. Okay, this is having four parameters, int, float, string, string, and this is having no parameters. So in every position, I mean in every declaration of constructor, you have its different signature. That's why it could allow me. Okay, so now what if I try to do it like this, chalo, let's from movie as a constructor, I want to call this parameterized constructor with two parameters. And if I say, let me pass these two values and let it call that parameterized constructor with two values. So here it will invoke this specific constructor. it will try to initialize year of release and profit with your values in that object. Your control comes back after this statement, and here if you try to set some producer name and some actor name like this, okay, here further you try to do it like this, okay, this also can be done. Means what? With a default constructor, I am trying to call parameterized constructor in a chaining way, but that constructor is only initializing some half number of instance variables. No problem, let your control come back to the original constructor, and if your original constructor, if it is trying to initialize remaining instance variables, that can be done. So this is again what? It is a constructor chaining. So let's try to experience it here. So if I'm creating object of movie in this manner, that is by saying movie Titanic is equal to new movie, and now if I want to see what are the values which has got initialized. So now are you remembering, I mean, can you just tell me what will be the sequence of execution of constructors in this, how they will be executed for this statement? If I'm saying movie Titanic is equal to new movie, so with new movie it will come where? It will come to default constructor. Okay, in default constructor, the very first statement, it is calling the parameterized constructor of same class, but there are two more parameterized constructors, no? So from that, which one will be invoked? It will invoke that type of constructor which is taking first integer and second float type value. So it will come up here, it will come into this constructor. For that Titanic object, year of release will be set by Y and profit will be set by P. After completion of its task, it will come back to the next statement. It will set producer name and actor name in that Titanic object, and that said, this is end of that constructor, right? So in this way, your movie object, I mean Titanic object, would be constructed. And if I want to see the details, okay, I'm saving the change and let's try to see it in output. So this is how it has got initialized. So this profit and year of release has got initialized by my values, whatever I have given, okay? So year of release I had given 2009 and this was the different value. So one constructor has taken care of initializing it. Another constructor has initialized your actor name and producer name. Understood? This is what? A constructor chaining, okay? But while chaining your constructor using this keyword, you have to take a precaution. What is that? Now see. If I think, chalo, when I said create a new object of movie by saying new movie, so my control comes here, and if I mention it like let this producer name and what you can say your actor name get initialized first. If you put this statements first and after that if you are putting this statement, then there would be problem. Then there would be problem. Means what? If you are trying to call one constructor from other, then for that, whichever this statement you are drafting, this statement, it has to be placed at the first in your constructor. So here what error it is giving, have you observed that? So constructor call must be the first statement in your constructor. If one constructor is calling other constructor, then that other constructor call, that statement should be very first in your constructor, then it is allowed. You cannot keep this in between or at the end. Are you understanding? Okay, so I hope you are clear with how this keyword can be used for constructor chaining as well. So we saw some three different purposes of using this. That is, it helps us to refer current object, it helps us to avoid shadowing of instance variables, and it also helps us for constructor chaining. Okay, so this is overall about your constructor concept. I'm just revising it in 2 minutes. So constructor, what is its need? That is to initialize instance variables at the time of creation of it. Okay, and what are the special characteristics of constructor? That is, constructor is a special method which name is same, or whose name is same as that of class name. Constructor can be, what you can say, with parameters or without parameters you can draft it. So constructor with a parameter, you will call it as a, with parameter means parameterized constructor, and constructor which is without parameter, you will call it as default constructor. While drafting constructor, you will not mention any return type of your constructor, not even void. Why? Because constructor never returns anything explicitly. Okay, but implicitly it returns what? A reference of that memory where that object has got allocated. So on left hand side we may receive it in that type of variable. Okay, so this is all about constructors. Okay.